Paripesa has a free bet for you as a gift if you bet 10 matches on AFCON. Make sure you register on the website or via the app with our promo code FANSTRIBE.
7 points from possible 9. 9 shots on target from 270 minutes. 9 shots on target. Equatorial Guinea, Nigeria. Nigeria, 7 shots. Nigeria, Cote d'Ivoire, 1 shot on target. Nigeria, Guinea-Bissau. Guinea-Bissau. Promo team, 1 shot on target. No. Bye-bye. No. Mm-mm. No.
The performance, you're not too fast.
No. If when you want to win AFCON, it's not like this. You can't play like this now. This is a team that considered 2 goals from an angry host nation. Concede 4 from Equatorial Guinea. Then to us today. And if there is one team in this group that's supposed to convincingly beat Guinea-Bissau because of history and everything, it's Nigeria. In that group, Guinea-Bissau, they're like Arsenal for their group in Champions League. Now, only they never touch this competition. They never win them. We are the most successful. In our group, we are the most successful. We have this. We have 3. Then you are playing Guinea-Bissau, who have conceded 6 goals before today. And you are managing 1 shot on target. And you want to tell me you can face Senegal. You can face Cape Verde. You want to play Burkina Faso like this now. Pesero don't qualify. Kudos to him. Second, yes. He really needs to go inside. If there is a drawing board in our dressing room, he really needs to go back there. Because this is not football. The whole first half was just like a mess. We can't complete passes against Guinea-Bissau. We were tested. We are under pressure. We couldn't play like a team. Against a team that traveled to AFCON just to help people. You see, people just underrate this team. Or not to people that this Nigeria Super Eagle team is made up of the best player in Africa. One of the most expensive signings in Serie A, Chukweze. We have people who won't be there and not there. Kevin Bassi did this team. Premier League players, ballers, starters in their team. And we can't play like a team. Okay, you decided to reshuffle the team today. See what Aribo they do for midfield. They said they call an emergency call today to come play. You they shake. You carry all the whole work now. Give Onyeka. No now. Okay, today Onyeka they on yellow. Is it Omero they on yellow? Is it Basi they on yellow? It's not done. This is the least we can do. So long as AFCON is concerned, there is no team we are going to meet that is going to be less than these people. No team is going to be at their level. I told you yesterday during the preview, I said, this is that game you really need to go to the bench. Call everybody back. Say, if you never play, come and play. It's not.
Still get results with you.
Still get results. On a very good day, we can bench Victor Osimhen and win this game. A firing team can bench Osimhen and win this team. Because they have been conceding goals. We are not playing. Forget that we are not playing. We can't come to AFCON, play a whole group stage with 9 shots on target. Score 3 goals. 3 goals. Equatorial Guinea has 9 goals. 9. Concede 3. Check him now.
Will he get to the point that we'll start needing to review the starting position of Osimhen?
If you review the starting position of Osimhen, who are you bringing? Okay, fine. Osimhen is not firing. We agree. But when Osimhen fell to fire, who fire? Is the team playing to him? During our first game, we were busy playing long ball. Even a team with a high-profile Ronaldo cannot just be playing for Ronaldo. You have a number 10, you have wingers. These people can take their chances. You must not pass to Osimhen every time. What were we doing? Look at the midfield. The entire first half, those guys took the midfield. They took the midfield. So we cannot comfortably play football comfortably against Guinea-Bissau. And we are here to win AFCON. The mediocres are on their way going. Now AFCON don't start. Now AFCON start. You got no excuse again. You've tried everything. Everything you'll be coaching now, one try. You don't try. So you don't get any excuse. Ordinarily, as you play cup tournament, your team they get more better. But we're not getting better. The level of inconsistency is second to nothing. You struggle against Equatorial Guinea, you drew 1-1. You up your game a bit. You beat Africa's. Today again, you go back. 10 steps backward. You were like, we started today. It's like this was our first game in AFCON. Okay, imagine say one Balino they turn up. Imagine say one Balino they turn up, I for B. I talk and say, there was no need doing this. Okay, fine. Akon had a little slight injury. No problem. Please, can you play Iwobi? Imagine when Iwobi came to this game, everything changed. Then I said, pressure those guys, score them goals. If you are winning 2-3-0, convincingly, you can look at the bench and say, oh yeah, come on, warm up. We played ourselves into their hands. We needed an own goal to win Guinea-Bissau. So in this tournament, Osimhen scored 1 goal, then we had a penalty and 1 own goal on our way to round of 16. It's a big shame. We are bigger than this. And with this performance, every true football fan, Nigerian fans, we should be worried going forward.
But then, is it better now, knowing that you have room to improve, rather than this same time last AFCON, we finished the group in 9 points, team of the group stages, player of the group stage, coach of the group stage?
Our game against Tunisia, to me, it was individual error. Individual error cost us that game. Not that we weren't playing well that day. We were playing well, but individual error cost us the game. So you can't say, to me, I cannot now say we are better now than then. No. In football, you really need to build on your results. That what makes you a team. When you win, you build on your winning. But when you start taking a step back, it doesn't make sense. Because you really need to be consistent. If you want to do well in a cup competition, you really need to be consistent, up your game, improve your game. So I can't say we are not better. As I told you, 270 minutes, 9 shots, 3 goals. The goals we've scored in the whole of this group stage, now go. Where Equatorial Guinea scored the angry host. First half. Can you imagine? Even if in the 90 minutes. You get so like to me, no. So long as I'm concerned, no. We are not better off. Whatever happened in our last AFCON has happened. I can't use that competition to judge this one. I cannot. We've not done well. Fine, we've qualified, but we've not done well as a super good team as Nigeria. We've not done well.
Moving forward now, I mean, but there were some good performance on the pitch today, Abi. Who are those players?
Of course, I know. Kevin Bassi has been there. Victor, people complain about Victor Osimhen. We can't rely on Victor. You saw him today. At the point, he was drifting in. He drifts in. And he's this player that when he misses the ball, he doesn't stand. He marks the ball. He tries to retrieve the ball. So, Victor Osimhen needed to play. Unfortunately for us, Boniface got injured and then went back. I missed Boniface here because you can't leave the whole thing on Victor Osimhen's shoulder. He played well. But you know, even as much as our conversion rate, our finishing is very poor. It's not just only him. Chukwueze has been guilty of that. Moses Simon today was missing. Aribo was missing in this game. So all of them need to up their game. But as long as Aina is concerned, Ola Aina, Kevin Bassi, even Kenneth Omero that hasn't played top. That leadership quality was there, just like when Ekong was there. As long as I'm concerned, we don't have problem at the back. All we need is to score goals. We need to score goals. Luis Van Gaal will tell you, you can't win a game if you don't score goals. Score goals. People now know that we are not scoring, and it's a problem. The way people will prepare when they want to face us, it's not the same way they're going to prepare when they're facing Equatorial Guinea. Because Equatorial Guinea, they have goals in their legs. We don't have goals. And we need to improve in our squad. If not, where we are going now is where you need to kill your game. When you get chances, you take your chances. If you don't take your chances, it will come back to hurt you. Because now, you play your first game in the group stage, you can make amends in your second game. Now you're going to play a knockout game. You lose. So when you fail to take your chances, it will come back to hurt you.
My final thought
is simple. Pesero should go back. Now the promo is over today. The boys, where he never played, he don't play them today. I pray all our small injuries recover, come back. Our next game in the round of 16, we must play our best legs. We lose.
Thanks for watching. Right here on another one of our videos where you're supposed to like, and all our social media links. I mean, follow us on every platform because we get content for you.